Steve, good to see you. I mean, how satisfying was that, particularly the first half?
Well, yeah, I mean, 3-0 away from home is a fantastic result at any time of the season. Never mind, you know, having not played for as many months as we have, and you know, having little preparation to get ready for the game. To, you know, to go 3-0 up as quick as you did, and you know, probably missed two easier chances, I think, without seeing them back with Aldo and Rian, is very, very pleasing. And, you know, it gave us obviously a brilliant foundation then to get a fantastic result. And I can't say I loved too much of the third goal to half time. And I think there's a few reminders to the boys to keep believing in the way we play, and, you know, on a hot day and, you know, on a lovely pitch, it's, you know, we want to play with the ball. I thought we lost that a little bit. We didn't quite get it up the pitch enough, but they took their message on board, and you know, still tried to play. Legs were getting tired. We made substitutions. You know, we defended a lot of long balls, a lot of set plays, and you know, we're good for the clean sheet, and you know, nearly got a fourth at the end with George hitting the bar and or the post, and Burson having a good chance as well. So. That's obviously, you know, a fantastic result, a great, you know, restart for us. Still stuff that we, you know, we will want to improve on, but that will always be the case. But, you know, it's important you enjoy, you know, victories like this away from home.
And the second half, as you alluded to there, was a lot more defensive. Was that because you perhaps told the players to ease off the gas maybe a bit in the second half and save their energy? Or was it just a natural kind of drop off and Middlesbrough sort of coming back at you?
Yeah, I think there's a, you know, you're never going to be up the press for the whole of the game in this weather, and you know where physical conditions are at the moment in players. But we were never under the cosh. I mean, there was a couple of good blocks in the box. Freddie's made some comfortable saves, but you know, unless I'm wrong, I can't think of any clear cut chances that Middlesbrough, you know, have created and missed. So. We were too deep at times in the game. There's no doubt about that. And I would have liked us to been a lot higher, and I would like us to kept the ball a bit better in the second half. But I get it. You know, tired legs, 3-0 up, the mentality is to get the win. And it's an important win as well.
We've seen glimpses of just how good Rian Brewster can be, Steve. But, you know, brilliant in the first half with the way he took the goals. Is that perhaps the best you've seen him play for you?
Well, you know, obviously, he first half particularly looked a real threat, didn't he? Got his two goals. He was disappointed he didn't have three. Yeah, he's a really good player, you know. But we are a team that likes to play as a team. You know, I thought, you know, Aldo was equally as a threat down the right-hand side first half. Andre obviously doing what he does week in, week out for him. You know, I thought the Conor Gallagher, you know, did brilliant. I think he won the penalty, Conor. Getting in the box and even the midfield players, you know, getting high at the pitch. Jay Fulton's pass for the penalty, you know, fantastic. So, yeah, Rian obviously will get some headlines today because he's got a brace. But you know, it's as a consequence of the team playing the way we want to play.
Just a word on his T-shirt that he showed after he scored the first goal, which said our colour is not a crime. I mean, just tell us why he wanted to support, clearly, the Black Lives Matter protests.
Well, we have as a club, you know, we did a picture ourselves at our training ground on Thursday, and obviously in collaboration with Middlesbrough and the officials today, we showed our support at the start of the game. You know, Rian has a voice like everybody else, and we all support each other. We're as one here, and it was just another example of that.
And how have you found the whole experience, Steve? You know, the travelling up, the staying in the hotel, and what it was like coming into the ground today.
Yeah.
You know, what's it been like?
Well, I've spent all my life coaching in empty stadiums. So this season has been a little bit different. I can see Gary Stonehouse laughing there. So not too different for me, if I'm being honest, but maybe for some of the more experienced people in the group. What we've said, Ian, is that it is different, you know, in terms of the travelling, the accommodation and the protocols around the ground. But it's not going to be an obstacle. You know, we're going to deal with everything in front of us as it comes, you know, and do it with a positive mindset and make sure, you know, there's a no excuse culture. And I thought we did that well today. We've got to continue with that mentality as well, even at our own stadium.
Do you think the players almost thrived on the fact there were no fans there in a strange way, because they weren't, you know, you didn't have that kind of hostile crowd on your back?
Listen, you'd prefer normal stadiums. You know, it's what makes, you know, English league football brilliant. You know, going to away grounds and the support, you know, you take support with you and you're against home support. You know, I don't want to say that anybody's enjoyed that, because it's, you know, we're in this situation and such a an awful thing that the country and the world has gone through. But it's the way it is at the moment, and you've just got to try and deal with it better than the teams that you come up against. But everybody will be thinking that. And, you know, today we talked all week about trying to create our own atmosphere on the pitch with our ball speed and our, you know, our togetherness. And, you know, I thought that's what got us off to a really good start, being very much a team.
Just final one from me. I mean, you know, you've drawn level with sixth place in the Championship. You've got Luton at home next weekend. It looks like you really sent the message out that you are genuine contenders for the playoffs again.
Well, we've always been in the mix, you know. We've never been too far away from the playoff positions, you know, if we haven't been in them. That will continue after this weekend and after Luton. And we've just got to make sure that we just focus on the next game, be as ready as we can for it. We've got a week now before next Saturday to try and get it right, and that's, we won't look any further than that. But, you know, obviously, you know, the games are getting less and less, time's precious, and, you know, we've got to make sure that we maximise it, you know, everything that's in our hands.
Well done today. Thank you. Thanks, Steve.
Thanks, Ian.
Afternoon, Steve.
Mitch, okay, mate?
How you doing, mate? Just want to ask you about your 1 year anniversary at the club last week. Was this possibly one of your best performances of your tenure so far?
I don't think it's about any individual. I didn't even know that until I think it was John's in the room here told me last week. It's irrelevant, really. I think that what I do know is we've had a fantastic win here away from home against a big club. You know, we've got some good players. That's the most important thing. You know, 3-0 away from home, I think, is our best victory of the season. And, you know, it will be hard to better that as well. So, like I said, we'll enjoy it, but we'll be ready again from tomorrow with our recovery to get ready for Luton next week.
You've spoken throughout lockdown and in your press conference on Thursday about how the mood's been really good since you've been back in Fairwood last month. What's the dressing room like at the moment? You've got eight big games and you're well in the mix at the moment, aren't you?
The dressing room is noisy at the moment. I mean, that's what I just said to the players there. And one of my reflections from the break is you've got to enjoy the victories. You know, and of course, you know, it's easy. Your mindset's got to be what's next. But I think for the players and the staff who've worked so hard, you know, they should enjoy the moment. And, you know, and then when we wake up tomorrow, we absolutely focusing on the next one. So it's a noisy dressing room, but very much a dressing room that is focused on getting better at the things that we would like to have done a bit better today, and keeping going the things that we did well. And that has to be our mentality. I said to the boys there, you know, it's a brilliant result. You know, but we're never going to apologise for wanting more, and you know, we will pick up some stuff with them on that.
And just a word on Joe Roden. We've heard he had a quad strain in midweek. What's the latest with him, and do you think he'll be available for Luton next week?
Not sure, to be honest. He's got a slight thigh strain. I've got to say, I thought the two bends were brilliant today at the back, defensively particularly. You know, if you think about the players that they've played against today, you know, from, you know, Gusted, and then Fletcher comes on, you know, they've looked, for their age, you know, let's not forget they're both 20-year-olds, or Cabango still might be 19, to look as confident and as composed as they did today against such talented and experienced centre-backs. I'm so happy with them. You know, that bodes well for us.
I know you want to concentrate on the team performance, but given what you've seen from Rhian Brewster at such a young age, how good a player do you think he can be?
It's down to him. You know, I've been fortunate to work with a lot of good young players over the years. And I think it's really important not to look too far ahead and concentrate on the present. And I think that's where Rhian is at the moment. I think he just needs to, like everybody else, you know, we've got a lot of young players, same age as Rhian, in the team. Just focus on making every day a good one, you know. And yeah, I mean, what's good for Rhian at the moment is he knows he's more or less going to be playing a part on the weekend. So he's got something to be focused on, something to get ready for, and I think he's thriving in that at the moment. So, like all of our young players, you know, it's up to them how far they want to get in the game. But what I do know is, you know, that you have to be professional, you have to believe in yourself, and you have to take opportunities. And you know, we're giving a lot of young players opportunities at the moment, and you know, and fair play to them. They're giving their best and really sort of making the most of it. And Rian's a good example of that.
Brilliant. Thank you.